What's up? Welcome to the start of the AI Scripters Championship. My name is Aleph, and I hope the stream works all right. I'm having some internet issues, but so I hope I don't get any technical difficulties today, but it should be fine. Tell me if the sound works okay, and then tell me when I'm streaming the game whether the stream is fine, just so I know. And yeah, AISC. So, tournament. This tournament has been prepared for a pretty long time, and the preparation took a lot longer than I expected, because there's a lot of things attached here. There's a lot more organizational stuff that needs to be taken care of than in other AI scripting tournaments that we've had so far. So some of the things you can already see on screen, and if you're part of our community, you already know most of them, especially if you've read the rules. So this tournament involves a lot more participation from the scripters that made the AI set participate, not just the AIs themselves. So before every match, the scripters actually have to go through a map draft to determine which maps they play on, like in some other games, for example Counter-Strike, and as human AoE games as well. And then they can also pick their civilizations for those maps. And this the map pool of this tournament consists of 7 maps. Those 7 maps, of course, are... I should probably have this up somewhere, but I can probably get them off the top of my memory. But the 7 maps are Arabia, Dust Bowl, Arena, Baltic, Fan Crazy, Land Nomad, and I'm probably, which one did I miss? Gold Rush that I missed. So those 7 maps, and yeah, there's a lot of variety in those maps, especially Fan Crazy is a classic AI map that has a lot of variety and is very random. Then we have obviously Land Nomad for the classic Land Nomad start, and Baltic, which is a water map, and Dust Bowl, which sees probably its first use in the tournament this time. And Dust Bowl is a map made by Trezini, and this is a... Well, we're gonna get into it in the first game anyway, so I can talk about that then. For now, let me introduce the AIs in the tournament and the stages. So this tournament just started. We are starting the group stage. There are 10 AIs in total participating, and they have been divided into two groups of 5 AIs each. You can see them here. Group A has Maya, the General, Ulysses, Thermopylae, I'm supposed to pronounce, and Eidolon. In group B, we have Tribal Warrior, Promi, Bambi, Cyan, and Ternary. And The first match will be Ulysses versus Thermopylae. Ulysses made by Ofo, Thermo made by Marathon. And at least Ofo's watching. What do you mean transcoding? What's transcoding? What are you talking about? Otherwise, I'm just gonna get into the game. Maybe you can tell me what you're talking about. On the stream, you can say that you can see the map draft as it played out. So Ofo banned Land Nomad, Marathon banned Baltic. And then Marathon had the first map pick with Dust Bowl, the new map. And then the other person, as you can see in the draft process, the other person who didn't pick the map can choose whether the map is played on 1v1, 2v2, 3v3, and 4v4. So Ofo picked 4v4 for that, then Ofo picked Arabia, and Marathon chose to play Arabia as a 3v3. So the two maps here will be Dust Bowl and Arabia. The group stage, all matches will just be two maps played, since it is a round robin. So each AI will play each other AI in its group exactly once, two games per match. And then at the end of the group stage, the final scores of the AIs will determine which place they take in the playoffs. I'm just going to show you the playoffs real quick so you see how they get seeded into the playoffs. Basically, all AIs in the group stage will make it to the playoffs, but 4 of them will go directly to the losers bracket, the lowest 4. Then the 4 above that will go to the first round of the winners bracket, and the winner of each group will go directly to the second round of the winners bracket. So the group stages don't knock anyone out, but the better you do, the higher you are in the playoffs. So that's definitely going to make it a lot easier. And it also means, as you can see, the lower bracket is pretty long. So even the lesser AIs will definitely see quite some play, unless they get knocked out in the first round. So, let's set up the first game. So, we have here a 4v4 on Dust Bowl, if I'm not mistaken, and the AIs are Ulysses times 4.
What's this cable here?
Versus Thermo. And they also each decided their civs for the map, and for Ulysses that will be the Aztecs and the Huns, the Persians and the Japanese. Whoop, where's Japanese here? And Thermo will play as the Byzantines, the Berbers, the Spanish and the Chinese. Just checking. Was that an empty can? No, that was my microphone cable. Checking the settings. Hard, yes. Standard settings, everything. And Conquest Victory. And thermostacking the team bonus. Yeah, we'll talk about that. But let's just jump to the game so you can see what the map looks like. Because it is, like I said, a very new map that hasn't seen much use. Even I haven't even tested any games on it. But some others have. And Ulysses is still spamming, as we know it. So, as you can see, Dust Bowl, each player starts with 12 farms, but no natural food sources. Nothing. That means no berries, no sheep, no boar, no deer, nothing of that kind. Just 12 farms. But I did the math on that. The food that the 12 farms yield does about equal the amount of food you would get from one patch of berries, your 8 sheep and 2 boars. So you don't have less food, it's just in a different form. Other than that, on this map, you can see on the minimap already that most of the wood is directly in the middle in one big patch. And the rest of the wood, especially around the player bases on the outside of the map, is just these very small patches, so a lumber camp isn't gonna last too long. Amlan says he's never even seen this map before. Yeah, you should have prepared for the tournament, but Amlan isn't playing any games yet, so he still has time to work on his AI. So, for Thermo, in the orange we have the Chinese. Very good team bonus, especially as it affects farms, but it doesn't affect the starting farms. That would be very much overpowered, because the starting farms in the map generation are placed before the civs are applied, and the farms just don't get the team bonus from the Chinese. But it's still going to be useful as soon as you drop more farms in Chinese. The food farm bonus is one of the strongest team bonuses in the game, in my opinion, so that's definitely very helpful in 4v4. And Thermo also has on the other flank the Spanish in gray, and they obviously also have one of the best team bonuses, if not the best team bonus, as in the better trade. You can already see gray has some problems here. It's taking wood, but it hasn't built a lumber camp. That's the build order many AIs have, is to drop the mill first no matter what, but obviously on this map the mill first doesn't really do anything, because there are no other natural food sources. There are only the farms, and they're already at UTC. But when you drop the mill first, you don't have wood for the farm as for the lumber camp at the start. So usually you have stragglers around your TC, but on this map you don't have stragglers, so you can't take wood from the stragglers first to build the lumber camp, because the TC is already surrounded by farms. There are no stragglers here, as you can see. So that's why it took Gray so long to build a lumber camp, because it dropped the mill first, and the villagers that went on wood had to carry the wood all the way back before they even had enough wood to build the town center. I'm imagining the other thermos had the same problem, but I didn't check. And yeah, continue with the sips. We have then the Berbers in purple in the pocket. Obviously a very strong cavalry serve. Should be especially good in the pocket. Spanish on the flank, not so good. They are a pretty weak flank, especially because they lack archers and stuff. So they are, especially in the early game, they are very vulnerable. So they should try to survive any way they can. And in teal, on the other pocket for Thermo, we have, what is that? The Byzantines. Not sure why they picked Byzantines here. I mean, this is a pretty solid civ overall, but maybe not one of the best. Maybe it's just a civ that Thermo is comfortable with. And on the other side, Ulysses. We have on the flank the Huns, just solid all-around civ. And the pocket, the Aztecs. Really good. Aztecs also one of the civs that's really good on this map. Like I said, there are only farms, there are no natural food sources. So obviously, civs like Britons and Franks that rely on natural food sources aren't as good, and especially Mongols, because Mongols don't have any early game bonuses other than the hunt bonus. And if there is no hunt, then Mongols would be really bad. On the other hand, Aztecs and Slavs are really good because they gather food from farms faster. So Aztecs and Slavs are probably the best civs on this map. So I like the Aztec pick here from Ulysses, and I'm kind of surprised that Thermo didn't pick Aztecs or Slavs. I would probably pick both of them just for that bonus. And then yellow has the Japanese in the pocket, and the other flank from Ulysses in green is the Persians. So Omlin said he's gonna ban this map. Okay, we'll see, we'll see. I mean, it shouldn't be too hard to adapt to. It's a relatively simple map. Pretty simple to Arabia mostly, but yeah, it's just a bit of a different start and the wood is different. And I'm assuming Thermo picked this. I mean, Marathon picked this for his AI because, well, one, Ulysses is an AI that hasn't been updated in a while. I think the last real update was like half a year ago in February or something. So it was never designed with this map in mind, which is maybe Ulysses cannot play it properly, but so far it looks so good. I wouldn't say that Thermo has any advantage yet. And meanwhile, I guess Marathon did work on the map himself, so and his own AI is based on his old AI, which was late, which was mostly a 1.0 CAI. Back then, you could only make farms because you had to make more farms. I mean, in the Dark Age, because you couldn't lure your boars yet. So it is pretty good at just farms. So I guess that's also one factor that goes into it. We already saw something I noticed here. Red, the flank, Hun flank from Ulysses is building a lot of towers. In my experience, that probably means it wants to sling. And Ulysses is an AI that really likes to sling, and it is pretty good at it. So I think that's a strategy we're going for here from Ulysses. And on the other side, Green is doing exactly the same thing. Already three towers, heavily on stone. I believe that means a double sling from both of the flanks from Ulysses. What do we have on the other side? People are going up to Castle Age. Looks like actually fast castling. Thermo, the flank from Thermo is fast castling. So that's a might be a response to the sling, might not be, but a lot of towers. A flush probably wouldn't have done much. So the fast castle from the flank is a good idea. And the same for the other flank. So both Thermo flanks are fast castling. Everyone on that team is fast castling. And you will forgive me if I maybe not notice anything or it takes me a while to remember some stuff. I haven't played this game or casted it or even scripted for it in a long time, so I need to get in the rhythm of it again. It's gonna take me something. Actually, you know what? I forgot to put on speed hack, so the game goes a little bit faster. Yeah, I might do that next game, whatever. Let's just keep it on fast for now. So, what did Ulysses do? Obviously, the flanks are both green and red. Yeah, the flanks are both still in feudal age, so it looks like they will be slinging. They're even building more towers. Green is up to six towers, one on pretty much each camp and a couple in the front. So that's a good defense. But it's not as useful to build the towers early on when both of the enemy flanks are fast castling, obviously. And we already see Gray as a Spanish going for a castle drop. The castle isn't in a good position, it's in the back. So the front of the space is completely unprotected, but castle drop is a Spanish. A good choice just because they build the castle faster and they're Castle Age units, the Conquistador is really good in the early Castle Age. On the other side, the Chinese flank from Thermo is going for 1-2 stable camels and knights, I guess, a mix of camels and knights. And I expect the pockets to also just go for knights. Already making janitors. Come on. Teal is going 2 TC, 1 monastery, 1 archery range janitors and monks? What is that? I don't know what that is. And purple also building a monastery. They really like the monasteries. And also an archery range and skirmishers. In the pocket. I don't know. Do you not have proper pocket strategies? That's not a good pocket strategy. And on the other side, can I check whether they have slung? Yes, we see a resource ascent. Green and red are slinging, and both of them are slinging blue. So blue should be the powerhouse here. This is the Aztec one. So I'm guessing that's a First Imperial Eagle Warrior Flood. You have the resources to go up. I'm guessing it doesn't have the buildings yet. It has 4 town centers? Why do you have so many town centers? It doesn't have the buildings to click Imperial. Now that's a serious bug. Doesn't have any university, any monastery, nothing. It cannot click up. That is a serious bug, Ulysses. Alpha, if you're watching this. If you're watching this, what the fuck? And yellow, on the other hand, looks like 1 stable, 3 TCs, so also booming very heavily. No military that I can see, so it should just be a straight up boom. Actually, it did have some knights that it sent forward, but they are idle right now. You could do a lot of damage on gray here, but they're idle. I wonder why. Gray is pretty much undefended. Yeah, there's the tribute coming in. And on the other side, nothing much happening. Thermo is making some military, but also not sending them forward, which might not be a bad idea just because there's so many towers here. Ulysses tries to wall a little bit. I don't know what that gate is. But you can see here, yellow at least has trying to do a house wall, but on the wrong side of its base. And once again, that's probably gonna block its trade, which is something Ulysses' trade often does. House walls often block its team's trade. So it often backfires just because of that. Let's see here, yellow. Where did yellow's military go? Oh, they're already trading, but Ulysses already trading, but trading in the front. That market, I don't know what that market placement is. I mean, this market is alright, but these markets are a bit too, I guess that's its first market that it's built to swing. But starting trade this early is probably way too early. There is regular amount of gold on this map, so trading shouldn't be needed until like another half hour. Yeah, Byzantines don't get cheaper janitors. I don't think they do. I think that the bonus only applies to regular skirmishers. I mean, I don't know if the tech tree says that. It only says camel, skirmishers, spear, and it doesn't mention janitors. So yeah, I don't think that's how it works. Okay, orange is finally moving out with its knights, but it's not that... Well, it's a good amount. Maybe like 12. Not that much. And there's still a good amount of towers. One of them already got converted by one monk here, I guess. They do have only one pierce armor upgrade, so they will eventually die to those towers. It's gonna take a bit of time, but it is enough critical mass to take down an isolated tower like here. It's just, attack isn't doing that much yet. Maybe after these three towers go down, they can do more damage. On the other side, yellow is gathering its army at the front of green, so playing defensive here. Gray also still being completely on the defensive. Where's blue? Blue is in Imperial Age finally. This is researching the Elite Eagle. And where's the barracks? Where's the barracks, man? Okay, it is making barracks. Oh, that is a lot of barracks, actually. Okay, they are just built all over the place. Like, look at how far away these barracks are from its base. And Elite Eagle's already all the armor upgrades, getting its final attack upgrade. So this Eagle Flood is gonna come into effect very soon, and it should be devastating. I hope it happens before Red... Shut up! I hope it happens before Red dies here, this attack. Now the Eagles are on the move, finally. They should be cleaning up this Castle Age army here with relative ease. But here comes... Why are you spamming, Ulysses? Why are you fucking spamming? Yes, notify Alpha if this message appears too often. I'm putting you on notice right now. This message appears too often. Yes, Avalon. And like I said earlier, it definitely had a very, very slow Imperial Age. It had all the resources, it just didn't have the buildings to click up. So that was one of the biggest bugs in this game so far, probably. The other bug that I noticed, obviously, in the early game was the mill first build order from Thermo, which is suboptimal on this map because there are no stragglers. So you have to build a lumber camp first, and you don't need the mill. So, I don't know. I mean, Marathon picked this map, so I don't know why he didn't at least fix the build order for this map. But the Eagle Flood is now hitting Orange, and Orange has nothing here to defend against this. Fully upgraded Elite Eagles, just missing the unique upgrade, obviously. And they are running Rampage here. The few single units and Siege aren't gonna do anything. They might even take down this TC. I don't know why they're attacking houses. They should not attack houses. As soon as you should kill all the villagers. When you kill the villagers, maybe kill a TC or two, but then move on to the next player. You shouldn't be stuck killing houses. That's bad for an Eagle Flood. Maybe they're going somewhere else now. Nope, they're still staying here. But basically, Orange is already dead. On the other side of the map, still nothing happening. Still, Yellow's Knights camping in front of Green's base. And Grey also not doing anything whatsoever. And actually, I haven't really seen any military... Yeah, Teal sent military, but Teal only made trash because it's Byzantines. So Trash also not gonna do anything against Eagle Warriors, so I expect Teal to also die very soon here. Purple on the other hand, what is that Berbers? Berbers making pikes and janitors? Well, you're Berbers, you're one of the best cavalry civs in the game. You should be making knights. You should be making pure knights, as many as possible. That's what Berbers are good at. Ofo, shut up. That's what Berbers are good at, knights. Not this shit. What is that? I mean, camel archers, yeah, they're not a bad unit. But you're also not making too many of them. You're mostly making trash. Yeah, just trash. Look at this trash, and you're not even using it. So Thermo, really bad at using its army. Grey hasn't done anything this entire game. Purple hasn't done a single thing this game either. So, if I had to call it now, I would say decisive Ulysses victory. Just because Thermo isn't doing anything. And the Eagle Flood is now hitting Grey. At least Grey does have the castle in the space, but it also has a mostly trash army. So, a couple of Kongs, but mostly janitors, skirmishers. That's probably the worst thing you can make against fully upgraded Eagles. Oh, it's building a second castle? So the defense here, these castles can kill eagles over time. And Blue's Eagles, I think Blue's Eagles are running a bit too much all over the place. They were gray then, but it wasn't enough to really make a difference. Then they fell back and ran back to Orange to clean up more houses. I don't know why. I mean, at least you got some siege rams now, so you can clean up the houses faster. But Eagle Flood, early Imperial Eagles should not be cleaning up houses. They should be killing things, human things, okay? At least finally, Thermo is on the move, purple. It's massive trash army here. Oh, the Berber trash army. It's on the move, it is rolling into into green. Slowly, very slowly taking down the town center because its trash doesn't do any damage to buildings and it doesn't have any siege weapons either. Thermo, I mean Marathon, not to you, make more siege. Grey, I mean Yellow sent its knights in, and they are doing actually a little bit of damage here, upgraded to Cavaliers now. I'm wondering whether Green and Red ever switched off of the sling. I mean, I guess Red took a lot of damage early on, it has a barracks. Green also made military buildings now, so it's still in Castle Age, it should be going up, yep, Green looks like it's going up to Imperial Age soon, and then it can make military, but I think it might die before then. Assuming, of course, purple adds some siege. But still has to contend with the yellow cavaliers now. And scorpions, also not bad. And yellow? Yellow's Japanese. I don't know why it's going for cavaliers. Might not be the best choice here. Samurai, on the other hand, are a good choice. And it is making samurai, but they aren't upgraded yet. They only have a single armor upgrade. And they don't have the elite yet, so if you have some more castles here, yellow, you should maybe build some more castles and make more samurai, or just spam champions, honestly. That should work well against this trash. Ofo, yes, I hope you all notice. So, well, just a few Cavaliers are obviously getting nice and easy. I'm actually underwhelmed by the Eagles. Especially because they haven't done much past cleaning up houses in Orange. They were stuck on that too long. They should have done to Teal much earlier. And now, I don't know, there's not enough mass on them. They're still stuck on buildings all over the place. And there's not that many anymore. I mean, Blue, are you pop-capped at least? No, Blue isn't even close to pop-capped. So now it's sending its Eagles, it's a few Eagles piecemeal. The enemies are all Imperial with fully upgraded units. So the Eagles aren't that amazing anymore. So it looks like the Eagle Flood has pretty much been stopped in its tracks after barely taking out one player, not even. Ofo, why do we have to spam this shit in all chat? Why? Why? What is this bullshit? Man. I don't know, should I disqualify Ulysses for excessive spam? Should I? Nah. It adds to the flavor. And trade. Yes, Thermo has also started trade. Has markets in good positions. Here and at least one market here. So Thermo, really good trade. Right in the corners of the map, that's really good trade. Thermo, Ulysses, I mean, on the other hand, not quite as good. You see the trade line is going in front of yellows and blue spaces. Maybe because of the walls, but I think mainly because of the market placements. So that is not an optimal trade line. It's going to be very vulnerable if Thermo ever breaks in here. And looks like purple didn't even go for green space. Purple instead is walking all the way through the middle of the map through this maze of forests here, just trying to pick off single Cavaliers and single Eagles, I guess. But Teal is now also on the defensive. Man, Thermo really likes its trash. I mean, Byzantine's full trash I can understand, except the Janitors, of course. But Berber's trash, that is not something I would suggest, or I would recommend, rather. Well, so far this game isn't really decided. Red took a lot of damage, but is still kinda just barely alive. Let's look at the populations actually. Sorry for the score. Red is at about 100 population, green is at 122. On the other side, Thermo Orange is at 85, and so is Thermo Gray. So the flanks, all of the flanks, have taken a lot of damage and are quite a far way behind. They're all around 100 pop, but the Ulysses flanks are a little bit better off. A little bit better. Wait, what's my game sound set at? Master volume? Yeah, the second lowest. So it should not be that loud, I hope. So, we got Teal on the offensive with its massive Byzantine trash army. Now also adding some cataphracts, but missing the elite upgrade for them. And it's not researching them either. It's researching monk upgrades. Monk upgrades? I don't see any monks from you. I don't know why you're taking them. You should be upgrading your cataphracts, mate. Janitors also aren't elite yet. Skirmishers, well, skirmishers of course. Pikemen also not halberdiers yet. Now it's getting elite janitor at least. Why are you getting... It just got some other unit upgrades like longswordsmen and stuff. Stuff that it's not gonna make. Okay, I guess you are making. I don't know why. You can just stick with trash as Byzantines. And Orange also army stuck, well, idle, more like. I mean, maybe it takes some time to retarget sometimes. And Blue is still full Eagles as far as I can tell. Full Eagles. And yeah, that's the right choice against trash. Maybe not against Cataphracts though. So the Cataphracts should be good at countering the Eagles. But Teal isn't upgrading them. Just isn't. On the other side, oh, we got finally yellow Japanese champions. That's what I was waiting for. These champions are gonna make short work of this trash. I guess camel archers should be champions, but purple doesn't have that many. How many castles do you have, purple? Purple is player 6, I think. 1, 2, 3. 3 casters. Okay, that's... So you should be able to pump out a lot of Camel Archers to counter these champions. So maybe it's gonna come... Oh! Hand cannons also! Even better choice. So at least they have I think Thermal can make some good counter units sometimes. You see now the hand cannons here, the direct counter to the infantry from yellow. Green never really got this military. Okay, it has finally halberdiers. They are fully upgraded and it's making siege too. Not sure if halberdiers are a good choice here because most of the armies are ranged here. Mostly janitors, some conks, camel archers. So halberdiers probably not a good choice. You should be making... What's the silver view? Persians. Yeah, maybe like camels? Maybe like skirmishers? I don't know. I mean, paladins are obviously the optimal choice, but you're probably not able to afford them. On the other side, yeah, Thermal is making progress finally on this side of the map. Siege Rams, Garrison Siege Rams actually. Nice one, Thermal. And a bit of still Castle Age units. Yeah, Orange and Grey still in Castle Age. So Orange still has Castle Age, but Castle Age Siege, well, it's not terrible. Battering Rams still do damage to buildings and are still good at tanking. And Scorpions, never bad. Always good in the big army to back them up. So on this side, Thermo is making progress, finally. On the other side, Thermo is also making progress. Maybe Ulysses' late game weakness showing, maybe... I mean, Ulysses did pretty much go all in on this double sling into the Eagle Flood, but that failure to be able to click up to Imp and then not doing enough damage with the Eagle Flood pretty much negated its impact. So Ulysses, yeah, chose the right strategy, but wasn't good enough at carrying it out, I would say. I was calling Ulysses' victory earlier, but after I saw that terrible Eagle Flood and yeah, then the flanks didn't really switch fast enough to military, I think. I think they didn't go to Castle Age early enough, they didn't boom enough, they didn't have enough economy to even get to Imperial and make the strong army, so the flanks for Ulysses came into effect way too late. They stuck onto the sling maybe too long and the slung player didn't have enough impact. So now it looks like a very good chance just for Thermo to win this one on his own map pick. So that's always a good sign when you can win your own map pick. If you don't win your own map pick, then you gotta have problems. Maybe we'll see that next match. So yeah, all players from Thermo are on the offensive and are making... But yeah, okay, finally Orange is up to Imperial Age, but Grey still isn't. Grey is still stuck in Castle Age. After over an hour of game time, Grey is still in Castle Age. That's not that great, especially because it has 150 pop. It should just save resources, go up to Imperial, and then... Which player am I spectating? You have so many resources, Purple. Just give some to Grey. Purple is pop-capped, and so is Teal. It's just these massive trash armies that move not fast enough and don't do enough damage. And yeah, just looks like a regular TSA here, so the units are prone to walking all over the place. So they don't push fast enough, maybe. But Thermo should still win. You know what, I'm gonna turn on Speed Hack now. Just gotta open up that cheat engine. Where's my cheat engine? Are you attached? I think you are. Is that the right key? Yes, that's the right key. So I have a double speed hack now, so the game moves twice as fast. I mean, Blues, Eagles, still a good shout against the trash, especially because you Thermo, all of the Thermos are making tons of trash, man. They really like their trash, especially their janitors. I don't know why janitors. I don't even think janitors are that great a unit. I think they're not as good as skirmishers. Let's compare the stats, actually. Less range. Yeah, it doesn't matter that much. Same attack. I think they cost a lot more, though, don't they? Well, Thermo likes them for some reason, and it is working, at least in this game. And now finally Thermo also bringing in the big guns, the trebuchets. the superior medieval siege engine that can launch 300 kilogram projectiles over 90 meters. Or the other way around. 90 kilogram projectiles over 300 meters, I believe. And siege rams, garrison siege rams, I always like that. Yes, Life says he wants Teal to make paladins. Teal? Why Teal? Nah, green should make paladins. Green is making bombards? Not sure why you want bombards right now. And hand cannons. Probably not a good idea against this ranged trash here, against these skirmishers and janitors. Camel archers, I don't know. They're probably also not good against camel archers. And yellow sticking with its champions. Once again, not bad, but also easily countered by ranged units. I mean, they are the best thing, and samurais now too. That's pretty much the best thing that Japanese can do in the late game. But Thermo should be able to counter that if it just makes... Maybe make less trash, Thermo. Make less trash and make more real units, okay? Make some real units for once. Jesus. Elite cataphracts at least. That's something. And the left side, Thermo's making a lot of progress, is raiding the trade. Who's making these cavaliers? Yeah, Orange is making the cavaliers. That's Chinese. Maybe not perfect, but also not bad. I would like to see some Chukonus, but Orange doesn't even have any castles. Or at least, yeah. The other choice would be like just Obelisks, Scorpions. Scorpions aren't bad. But they're not upgraded. Oh, Rocketry Research coming in from Orange, but no Elite Scorpion. No Elite Scorpion. So Thermo sometimes has some problems prioritizing its researches, right? It sometimes got researches that weren't very useful and didn't get the military upgrade soon enough. That's a trend I noticed already. And it makes way too much trash for my taste. Yeah, here, Halberdiers fighting Eagles. Not good. Really not good. Where's Teal's army going now? I think they're just running all over the middle of the map chasing single units. But as long as they have some good enough siege rams and trebuchets, they should be able to push in eventually. Look at this death ball. That's so many ranged units. That's Conquistadors and Elite Camel Archers. Conquistadors also maybe not the best option for the Spanish in the late game. You might want to make paladins or even just hand cannons. Hand cannons are probably better than conks, especially against the yellow infantry. But also, maybe a few more siege rams wouldn't hurt, but that's enough to slowly push down these bases. Tower going down, barracks going slowly down. And it shouldn't take much longer for green here to get completely wiped out. Still at 100 pop though. A green, yes. So now all Thermos are pop-capped. All Thermos are pop-capped, Ulysses far from it. So Thermo in a very dominating position. Finally we have the veteran ramps taking down Green's TCs. Green's still making army. Won't be able to much longer. On the other side, Teal also still pushing, but yeah, the army is pretty dispersed. That's some onagers. And siege rams. Siege rams and trebuchets is really what you need in the late game just to push effectively. There are still castles up. Yeah, there's a bunch of castles in the middle here. Yellow doesn't have any castles anymore, I don't think. I don't see any. Maybe they already got wiped out. There's one here, only one. Yeah, now Thermo basically pushing on all fronts, even in the middle here. And the trade is definitely hit. The trade is getting hit. So Ulysses' trade is also suffering, so the economy should be dead pretty soon. Now they're pushing into the middle castles here. At least there's trebuchets here, two of them. So these castles are gonna go down eventually. And blue isn't repairing them. Probably can't afford to anymore. And yeah, also, Thermo also likes to add a few monks, which isn't bad. They just run behind the army and heal. That's always good. And they try to convert sometimes. And did get some upgrades for them that I saw. Yeah, this big army here is still pushing, but also the range team is getting stuck on buildings. Not ideal. But slow but steady progress is still progress. And it shouldn't take much longer for Yuli to go down. I'm wondering why they're not pushing to the left side yet. Okay. Teal also. Bombard cannons to solidify its map control. Yeah, and red is making, yeah, it's Hunt, so of course it's making Cav Archers. Where's the main push from Thermo? It just looks all over the place. All over the place. Not hitting any spot decisively. We just ran into here and just killed all of these villagers, all this trade. Then maybe this game would be over quicker. And still a lot of trash, but also unique units. Except for Orange. Orange never made castles enough castles. I mean, it has a few castles. Two I see. I don't think it's making Chukonus though. They would be a good choice. Better than trash at least. Because trash against eagles is just never gonna work. What are these units doing? At least, yeah, the trade. It looks like a lot of trade. Let's see, trade units. Yeah, all of the... actually, Thermo doesn't have... Ulysses still has more trade than Thermo. Maybe Thermo should trade a little bit more, but Thermo has at least the Spanish pick. But that makes trade significantly faster. Ulysses, on the other hand, did not pick Spanish. So, not that trade bonus for them. No trade bonus for them. So, yeah, Thermo's trade is... gives them a lot of gold income that they can just spam on their mostly unique units that they're making, and some siege. The rest is still trash. Now they're hitting the trade full time. I guess Yuli just keeps making new trade cards whenever they die. That's also costing a lot of gold and they just die again. And Ulysses can't really hold anymore. Population caps, green is now down to 50 pop. Even yellow is down to 120. At least, I don't know how red is getting up there again. I guess red is rebooming here in the back, in the left corner of the map. Yeah, red has reboomed a little bit, but because the pressure from Thermo in this corner hasn't really held up. Now blue is making Jaguar Warriors. I'm not sure that... I mean, there were some pikes in the mix, and they're also good against Skirms. But, I don't know, probably not the best choice. Eagles would have been better if you can afford them. Okay, finally we see the Orange Chukonus. Took you long enough, Orange. They are fully upgraded as well. So they are gonna do a lot of damage. They're definitely gonna help. They're also much better at taking down buildings. If your ranged units are attacking buildings, then you better have Chukonis instead of skirmishers. At least that's much better. Ooh, that's a lot of villagers that are heading to their certain death. Green is getting cleaned up. Yeah, Gray's army still stuck on green here, cleaning up. But cleaning up, not that bad. Maybe if you had some real siege and or just more champs. But just skirmishers, yeah, not that great at cleaning up buildings. Here, the castles still stand, and I guess they have been repaired, but now the army from Teal is here in full force, and there are some siege ramps, so this castle is definitely going down, I hope. And the siege ramps can move on to the next castle, and yeah, there are even more siege ramps coming in, so these castles are finally getting taken down. But that's also not red's Cav Archers arriving from this direction, I guess. And this is all over the place. The armies from Thermo are never grouped up. Often they're just running back and forth, and sometimes they're stuck on buildings. Especially being getting stuck on buildings just slows them down so much. Yeah, cleaning up houses. Why are we cleaning up houses? You should probably set better targeting priorities. Like, what's it called for TSA? Defensive priority, I believe. That's what you need to set. But yeah, this is... Red is finally down again, down to below 80 villagers, population I mean, as is blue. So now they've pretty much lost everything. Now it's just a matter of time before Thermo can finally clean up the rest of the buildings to really end it. Maybe Ulysses should probably resign pretty soon. I'm just gonna go grab another beer real quick. It's so fucking hot. It's past midnight now, and it's still. I'm sitting here with in nothing but boxers, and I'm still sweating my balls off. I hate this weather. Maybe a bit more siege would be good. I guess it just keeps dying. I only ever see like 2-3 siege rams in the same place, and 1-2 trebuchets. If you made more of that, then the push would go faster. But at least you're sending a steady supply of them. Why is Ulysses not resigning yet? The highest population is 75 from yellow. And the rest of them are all below 50. Red is just completely dead at 5 pop. Finally, the last of the castles here in the front. Well, not the last, but a lot of them, pretty much all of them are down now. It's just a few left. They stretch back into the back here. Now, here we go. Resigns. Blue and green have resigned. Yellow and blue, not yet. Red and green, I mean. Why do two of your players resign and not the rest? What? That's a weird resign rule. If you're gonna resign, resign it's your whole team. Come on. So anyway, Thermo wins the first game. That's a very good showing, I would say overall, pretty solid. It had some minor flaws, especially didn't like the research prioritization and the army compositions. But overall, Thermo much more solid than Ulysses. Ulysses just completely failed at its chosen strategy, even though it chose a good strategy. It just couldn't execute it well. And this was Thermo's map pick. So Marathon, good choice. Definitely made good use of it. And that's the first game for Thermo. Let me update these scores. This is the first time I'm using a proper overlay. I spent pretty much half the day today just designing the overlay. So we have 1.4 Thermo. The second game. Yeah, look at that woodline. The second game will be a 3v3 on Arabia. Arabia was the map picked by Ulysses, by Ofo. So, let's set this, and Ulysses. I'm not quite sure why Ofwo picked Arabia here. Maybe Ofwo in the chat, you can explain it if you're still here. And the civs are for Ulysses. Where is it? Arabia. Vikings. And the Mayans and the Spanish. For Thermo, we have the 3 MA civs. Malay, Malians, and Mayans. They all sound the same. Whatever. And yeah, map is gonna be Arabia. The Arabia version for this tournament is HC2 Arabia, which is a little bit modified. Less extreme hills, no lakes, of course, and I think the wood lines are a bit more consistent. Is that all correct? Ulysses, Vikings, Mayans, Spanish, Thermo, Malay, Mayans, and Mayans. Yep, looks good. Let's get into it. 3v3, I'm gonna turn off speed hack for the start. And we have on Ulysses' side in the pocket here, the Vikings, probably not good. I think, especially like we saw last game, Ulysses really likes to sling. So I'm guessing it picked Vikings with that in mind. So you probably would have wanted to have the Vikings in the flank, so you could have done the same thing it did last time. Just tower a ton, and then just sling whoever is the one you want to sling, probably the pocket. Then Mayans in the flank, and then the other flank, the Spanish. Again, Spanish in the flank, this time from Ulysses. Not that good, because, yeah, weak in the early game. And, well, Spanish, as I said last time, an extremely good team bonus, just the better trade. Much more important in the 4v4, or much better in the 4v4 than in the 3v3, but still good in the 3v3. Now, the Civ choices from Thermo are really interesting. Really interesting. We have Malay, and we have Mayans, and we have Malians. I can barely pronounce this, they all sound the same. yes, especially the obviously Mayans are a very solid Civ, just one of the strongest late game Civs in the game, extremely solid, and especially in team games, they're just a Civ that pretty much always gets picked, so here both of them pick them. Makes sense. On the other hand, Malay and the Malay and the Malians, they are obviously WK Civs, not AOC Civs, but they are pretty unique. Both of them are pretty unique. The Malians, they obviously have the bonus that they advance to the ages faster, so you basically get, once you click up, you are faster in the next age. That gives you more time in your TC to produce villagers, but it also can give you some timings on specific strategies you want to do. You just get up faster. The problem is only that you have to maybe adjust your build orders a little bit and your uptimes to make the best, to get the best advantage out of it. But other than that, I think that's really the only bonus that really defines the Malay, because their military honestly isn't that strong. Let's look at their tech tree for a second. I mean, they get Obelisks and Bracer. And they get Seatram, yeah. No, I'm looking at Vikings. What the fuck am I doing? They do get Obelisk and Bracer though. And yeah, the Karambits, maybe they take less pop, but they're obviously not that strong of a unit. They're not that important. Their cavalry is trash. Their infantry isn't that good. Even their elephants. The elephants are obviously cheaper, but they lack two of the armor upgrades. So you can spam them and they're alright in Castle Age, but in PvP they just die too fast to ranged units. So I don't like the Malay army options at all. I think they're just not that strong in the military sense, but they have a very strong economy in the early game, especially because of that because of that faster age up bonus. And so they play more like Vikings or Aztecs that just rely heavily on their econ bonus and don't have that great of a military. Malians, on the other hand, have very strong military, but only very few options. But the few that they do have are insanely strong. They have the champ skulls, the extra armor on the infantry, which makes them extremely versatile and strong. And they also have the cavalry unique tech. Oh, you're gonna lose a villager. Ooh, hoo-hoo, Thermo, what was that? That villager turned around. That might be some DOC bug, but you just lost a villager there to that boy. Yeah, and the unique tech for the cavalry gives them more tech, but they don't have the last upgrade on their cavalry, on their hussar. They don't have hussars, they don't have paladins. But to trade that off, they get more tech on their cavalry. So they can have pretty good cavalry, especially if you mask them. But you really have to choose wisely what you go for Malians. You can definitely get countered, but If the opponent can't counter your champ skulls, for example, then that can win you the game outright. And of course, Mayan pocket, especially in the pocket, just the Mayans are perfect. They can just get to the boom in peace or kinda in peace, then just in the late game go for plumes, go for eagles, they are so strong in the late game. I don't know what we're gonna see from Ulysses here. I was saying that I expected a sling, especially because of the Viking pick. I don't know if the Vikings will be the ones slinging though, because they are in the pocket. Oh, Once again, spam from Ulysses. I'm used to that by now. Oh, do you see that? Ulysses is cheating. Oh, disqualify. No. I don't know what the chat means, but I'm guessing it's not really cheating. It's just trolling us. Ooh, four villagers on gold without a camp. Okay, there's the camp. A bit too late. You're putting a lot on gold early on. Nothing on stone, so I'm guessing red is going for archers. Makes sense as the Mayans and not slinging. Green. Oh, stable. A scout. Is that a scout rush from the Spanish? Would make sense. It's one of the things Spanish can do in the flank. And the Vikings in the pocket. Later feudal age, so looks like a fast castle. So I don't think we're gonna see a sling from Ulysses this time. Oh, Offo says the cheating message meant it's cheating zero resources. That reminds me of the prize pool of this tournament. It's also $0. So whoever wins this entire tournament gets $0. That's big stakes for our community, okay? So, we have now Ulysses flanks were faster up the feudal age. Then Teal at least. And Teal is going for stable black. Oh, they're going fast castle again, I think. I think Thermo. And is yellow also going for a fast castle? What is yellow doing? Yellow. Oh, yes, it is going for a fast castle. So, no defense in the feudal age. Looks like, just like last game, Thermo doesn't really have any feudal strategies. It just goes straight fast castle, even with its flanks. That's extremely risky, especially if you don't make towers. And it isn't making any towers. So, it is very vulnerable. And green has the scouts. Green has the scouts. Why are you standing still? Why are you useless, mate? Why are you fucking useless? Just run your scouts in here and kill some villagers. It's completely undefended, mate. Just go for it. Jesus. Ulysses, use your army. Red is also going for a fast castle with archers, obviously, as the Mayans. Oh, is it? Oh, no, sorry. I wasn't the wrong player. I was talking about yellow. Four men at arms, not using them. Eagles, not using them. What's with Ulysses' idle army in feudal age, man? What's with the idle army? I hate your spam. I hate your spam, too. Yeah, Ulysses, man. Ulysses, you would have had the perfect counter with your feudal units. Because Thermo is completely undefended. Thermo is completely undefended. You have the military. You're just not attacking. Let me check something real quick. Yes. Ulysses has scouted. At least yellow. So you know where the enemy is. You're just not attacking. That is so stupid. Now, yellow in castle age as the Malay and as Teal. Oh, where's my Teal? Here's my Teal. Teal is also in castle age. So both of them are in castle age. Teal is going for the knights as the Malians. And the Malay are going for trash. What is this? I hate your fucking spamming shit AIs. Wow! Cheating again, yes. Yeah, I don't know what Malians, yeah, I already said Malians have shit military, but you don't want to do trash against the Eagles from the Malians here. Like last game, Eagles hard counter all trash. Not much action yet. They're making army. None of them are using their army though. It's so frustrating. That means turn on speed tech. Yep. Is it on? I think it's on. No, it's not. What the fuck, speed hack? Here. Do that. Do this. I said do this. Oh, I've had it on slow, that's why. Okay. Never mind that. blue. As the pocket, the Viking pocket is going for a Night Rush. Definitely the best option here. And at least that one is attacking. And yellow had Spearman here to defend. They just didn't really... They stood still here. I guess they were going towards them. Please tell me they're gonna attack this knight. I don't know what these units are doing. Okay, at least now the knights are dying. And I think it got a couple of villager kills around the TC here. With its first wave of knights. And red building a tower in the middle. Not sure. And red not using his army. I mean, blue was attacking yellow. Red has its army right here and still didn't move it. If he had attacked at the same time, it would have been so much better. Now, finally, it's moving. Way too late. And it is going to make short work of these spearmen, that's for sure. But there's still a TC in the way, but I think red can still do a lot of damage here. On the other side, absolutely nothing is happening. Not a damn thing. Not a thing. Purple, once again, Thermo Syndrome. Units not moving, has a large army in the pocket, not doing anything. Eagles and crossbows. Yeah, good army, good army. Crossbows have the upgrades. Eagles don't have any upgrades. That's bad. They don't even have the Eagle Warrior upgrade. But I guess the armor would be more important. Now, oh, even the... Yeah, yellow is so dead. Okay, it has two TCs. It's building... That's a market. It has two TCs, but yellow is down to 44 pop. That's half of the other players. So yellow is already pretty much taking out. It's once again looking good for... No, it's looking good for Ulysses this time. Sorry. And this is also Ulysses' map pick. Obviously, Arabia is pretty much the most standard map you can have. So every AI knows how to play it. Most AIs are tested mostly on Arabia. So each AI, all AIs are good on it. I'm not sure why Offro picked it. It's just standard map, I guess. He's probably not that confident on the weirder maps. But so far it's definitely working out. Yellow is pretty much out of the game, down to 30 population. And even the TC might go down here, but it has another TC. It's gonna take a long time to reboom though. Purple's army was on the move, but then it stopped again. Blue's knights are crossing, running straight through the crossbows. But they don't have ballistics from the looks of it. Ulysses still cheating. Still cheating. Why is it always cheating? Is this just a message that's on a timer or something? And blue is up to Imperial Age. So first one in Imperial Age, also blue. Faster than purple, so blue in Imperial Age. I'm not sure what's gonna go for. As Vikings, maybe Alps or Champions or something. Maybe just Cavaliers at the start. Ooh! Villagers attacking crossbows. This is only two crossbows, but they are losing villagers, man. I guess it works strength in numbers here. Green and teal still not doing a fucking thing. Oh, there was some action here, but looks like didn't do much. Two towers in the same spot, okay. And green also, once again, is the Spanish. This time Ulysses has a castle and is making conks. Could come into play, though maybe not the best against camels. Yeah, looks like the Thermomalians is staying on mostly cavalry, which isn't bad. And now we have finally even have some battering ram, one battering ram coming in here from red. Blue once again not using its army. I mean, when red is attacking, when one of you is attacking a player and you are also close, you should just attack the same player. Blue finally cavaliers. Still not using them. Now would be the time to use them. Now would be the perfect time to use them, just when you get the upgrade. And Ulysses getting Blast Furnace before... I don't know, do Vikings get the last armor upgrade? I guess not. I don't think they do. Actually, I'm pretty sure they don't. Would make sense that they don't. Yeah, they don't. Not a cavalry, Sif. So use your cavaliers, man. Use them. Is it still making them? Should probably switch to something soon. Maybe champs. But yeah, still making cavaliers, but... They're just gathering at this tower. Why are you not attacking? Why would you not attack? That makes no sense. Now green also up the Imperial as the Spanish flank. Even the flanks from Ulysses are faster on Imperial than Thermo. Than the Thermo pocket. That is terrible, man. That is terrible, Thermo. It's not even trying to go up, it's not even saving resources. It's close to pop limit, just never got the resources. So all of the Ulysses now in Imperial Age. This game is gonna be over soon. If just blue would use its army at least. Yellow, zero population, completely wiped out. And red at least is attacking purple and killing a lot of villagers here with its egos. Purple has the army, it just never really used it. But it is mostly trash and eagles, yeah, said it enough times. Eagles just wrecked it. At least the castle went up now, but it lost so many villagers already. Look at the economy, and all thermos are fully boomed. All Ulysses, I mean, are fully boomed. I mean, I guess so are purple and teal, but they lost a player and they didn't get anything in return. Blue, man, blue! What the fuck am I even looking at? That's stupid. I mean, I guess it's not a pop cap, but come on. Green, however, is on pop cap, and now it's finally attacking. Green also went for cavaliers. It's researching pikemen and ring archer armor. I don't know why you're researching pikemen. You're not making any. Maybe it's gonna make them later against the cavalry here. Green finally on the attack, should also be able to take out teal, because teal still... Oh, teal actually did go to Imperial, so teal is the only thermo that made it to Imperial. But... I don't think it has enough army here to really defend. Oh, look at this! These military units. They are in the back of the base, standing around while the front of the base is getting attacked. That's probably related to some SNs, but not using a military to defend your own it's not even using its military to defend its own base. Come on, Thermo. Oh, look at that! Blue finally on the move after I don't know how many minutes that was. Long enough. No, red is stuck. And these idle units are getting really old really soon. Oh. I mean, I guess purple is still in Castle Age, so that's not even a good army. And if that Death Ball of Cavaliers just runs into here, they should be cleaning that up easily. But they aren't, of course, they're just idling again. Motherfucker. What's that? TC from purple in the back of teal, and TC from teal in the back of purple. I guess they really like each other. Where's the paladins? Attacking teal right in front of the castle, not gonna work. And green still attacking at the front. Still attacking in the front. Teal has at least some melee units so that it could take out these siege rams. But it is backed up by a couple of Kongs and hand cannoneers, and there's more coming. Look at that. No mining camp here. And this one is overcrowded. Red still slowly trying to attack purple, and I think red is still killing villagers here every now and then. And purple never made it to Imperial Age. That is so disappointing. Yeah, look at that, it doesn't even have any food. And Thermo is really bad at spamming. It's worse than Ulysses at spamming. Jesus. Ooh, green paladins. Nice. Not that many of them. I think Thermo tends to make too many unit types. Like you see here, paladins, kongs, halberdiers. I mean, I guess that's alright. Should work at least. And yeah, teal down to 100 population doesn't really have any military to defend with anymore. And once again, Thermo's stuck on cleaning up buildings, but it's gotta work. This is Ulysses, I mean, sorry. It's Ulysses stuck on cleaning up buildings. It is also making some siege rams. Yeah, it's making sea drums. That's good. And even... No, there's more sea drums. Yeah, a lot of sea drums, actually. That should be good. Red units idle. Blue doubling up on teal. Nice, finally. Infantry from the Vikings. Elite Berserks and Champions, really good at cleaning up buildings, so that's gonna work much better than the ranged units here. And teal is probably a goner. 70 pop now. Yeah, this is getting cleaned up very fast. Sea Trans finally coming in. And red is finally attacking again against purple. I mean, purple can still... Oh, purple finally somehow made it to Imperial Age. Did it get upgrades? Yeah, no armor upgrade, no attack upgrade yet. No elite upgrade. So no upgrade on the Eagle Warriors whatsoever. At least it has a bracer and chemistry. No elite plume either. So purple can't really afford... Look at the resources from green. This is ridiculous. All of them. All of the Ulysses are pop-capped and have so many surplus resources. It's gonna be impossible for a Thermo to even try to turn this around. Looks very comfortable for Yuli. Yeah, so yellow died early, the melee, and they got doubled. They got doubled by blue and red, even though they were taking their turns idling their entire armies. But still wasn't enough to take them out, and they didn't really... I think yellow didn't really have a strategy of what to do. They just made some... In the early game, they just made some trash and castle age, while red made eagles, so yellow was just dead by default. And after that, it was just easy pickings for Yuli. Now, yeah, teal is dead, 15 pop, almost all of its buildings gone, and as soon as that happens... Oh, this time Ulysses is making bomber towers, so we saw now both AIs building bomber towers to just make sure that the enemy cannot push back, to make that map control solid. Even forward castles here from Ren, also good. Yeah, once teal is cleaned up here, then all of the three armies from Ulysses are just gonna run into thermo, into the purple thermo, and even purple is already down to 60 pop. They're just getting the military has been wiped out, their villagers have been picked off left and right, especially in the front here. So even purple is dead. I hope thermo has a good resign rule, because it should already have resigned. What are you gonna do when Ulysses cheats? Yeah, no chance. Oh, no greens idling. Despite being literally pop-capped. Nice idle, bro. Nice. And sea drams running to the other side of the map. Whatever. Red stealing resources. Why not? Come on, green. Yeah, you gotta explain that offer. You're pop-capped, the enemy's already dead. You're still not attacking. At least yellow resigned after being on zero pop for half an hour. But they're still attacking yellow farms, why not? It's only really blue that's even attacking purple, but even that should be enough. Purple down below 50 pop, why aren't you resigning? Oh, Thermo doesn't resign, Offo says? Marathon, put in some fucking resign rules. Put in some... Okay, I guess I'm ending this game manually then. That's a easy victory for Ulysses. So, that makes that a score of 1-1. Bam! So, each of the AIs won their own map pick and lost on the enemy's map pick. And both times it was relatively comfortable. And both times the one that lost made so many serious mistakes that it definitely deserved to lose. And I mean, both AIs had some bugs in both games, but usually the winner had less bugs, which makes sense. Oftentimes AI battles are a fight of who bugs less.